was born in West London, the daughter of a movie producer and an actor. However, took the crown of Princess of Pop all on her own. She signed a record deal but did things her way, posting music demos on her MySpace page. 32 million downloads later, she'd transformed from cyber celebrity to worldwide phenomenon, with her debut album All Right Still selling a staggering 2.5 million copies. Now she's back with more cutting social commentary delivered by the voice of an angel on her chart-topping second album, It's Not Me, It's You.
It's her, all right. Please welcome Lily Allen. Lily Rose Beatrice Allen, welcome.
How do you know my full name?
Well, I've heard that you don't get... You would want more people to call you by your full name, and I thought I'd indulge.
Well, my real name is Lily Rose, but Beatrice is the middle bit. You don't have to say Beatrice.
But I choose to.
OK.
You want to rumble? Is that what you're saying? You want to rumble?
I'm ready to rumble.
We could make this. We could make it happen right now.
Come on, here we go.
I fight like a girl.
I fight like men.
I can. You might. I've got a fighting style.
Really?
Where what I do is I I have a fighting style where I talk. Can kick the shit out of me. Ready? You want to stand back? Stand back. I'm gonna go. Octopus on your ass. Congratulations, your first ever number one album, and we did it for you in this country.
Really?
Congratulations.
My first?
That was it. That's great.
Congratulations on having the hottest shoes I've ever seen.
Yeah.
Miff and I are drooling over
here. We just looked at each other and went, oh, my
you
God.
You know what? I stole these.
Really?
Yeah. Well, I say I stole, but I just did a video shoot for my next single, and these were what I wore in them, and I just nicked them.
Great. I was thinking you'd actually gone to Speeds, which is a local shoe store here, and gone there, so well done.
Now, you're a MySpace Facebook person, aren't you?
And do
you?
Some would say.
Do you Twitter as well?
I do Twitter.
Can you explain it to me? What, do you get into it? How often do you Twitter? How often do you do all the updates and downloads and all that kind of stuff?
I do it, like, you know, probably like 10 times a day or something.
How do you keep... This is what I don't understand. How is it... It's meant to be a social networking thing, but with all the updates...
I think it's an
anti-social
networking
exactly,
thing.
Exactly,
because
exactly.
You just basically don't communicate with human beings on a human level anymore. It's more just a cyber thing. but, yeah, I mean, I'm lucky in the sense that I have a BlackBerry and I can do it while I'm, you know, sort of travelling around and working. It's not like I kind of race home back to my hotel and kind of sit online and doing it. I can do it while I'm in a cab or something.
It's such a great thing, though, Lily. Like, I don't know you at all, but I feel like I know you.
I feel like I know you too.
Oh. I've been sort of reading, I get your updates. I go, oh, yeah, you're in Japan. That's nice. And then, you know, I saw you got a new tat and I went, that's nice. And, you know...
Once upon a time, that was kind of like called stalker
that's
or something,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Now, that would be my concern, that, you know, do you worry that you're giving out information to people that you don't know, that they could track you down if they need to, or just bug
you? Yeah, actually, you know what, interestingly enough, because I've only been on Twitter for like a month or something, but the other day I was in Los Angeles and I was, you know, I hung out with, you know, a friend of mine, Lindsay Lohan, and I got a Twitter from her father going, dear Lily, I think you have an alcohol problem that needs to be addressed.
From her dad?
Yeah. From Michael Lohan. I was like, leave me alone.
Yeah, exactly. is that where you got the matching tattoos?
Yeah.
Oh. You've got the little shh on the finger.
Yeah, but I since found out Rihanna's got the same thing, so it's not really... I mean, she's very cool, but you know what I mean? It's like, thought I was being original.
Is Lohan handing out the tattoos?
I'm really not happy with the way I can see myself here. I'm just going to sit in a way that makes me look a bit thinner.
You look fine. You look fantastic.
Okay.
worry about what you say? I mean, I've been listening to the album and I love it. There's a song on there called It's Not Fair, which is pretty much about a dud route that you had. Some guy who was no good, he was a great guy, wonderful, charming, just seemed to love you to bits, and then got upstairs and he's done. He's done.
Yeah, it's not very good.
Is that based on a true story?
Yep.
Does he know it's about him?
No.
Can you tell him now?
No, I did actually play it to him. I mean, but he is such an arrogant person. I mean, I played it to him and he was like, who's this about? I was like, you. But he didn't realise. He didn't for a minute think that it was.
Is he anyone we know?
No.
Intriguing. Now, here's my thinking would be, now for you, it must be difficult to find a guy, get a date, because every guy would be petrified. If I'm a loser in bed, if I don't do a good job in any way, shape or form, everyone's going to hear about it in a song.
Well, I don't know about that. You know, I've always been, you know, I kind of only ever really go out with people that are sort of friends and stuff, or people that I know. But I've definitely noticed in recent times that guys are really nice on the letdown front, you know? They're not really, they don't just not ever call me again, because they know it'll end up in a song. But it's... They're kind of, like, really nice about it.
Well, yeah, you
I really like you, but... Yeah, that kind of thing.
You probably find some who will use the excuse of being bad sexually. Just say, oh, no, I just wanted to have a single written about me. That's all it was. Like, I'm normally really good. Like, really, really good.
Yeah.
I'm going to use that if ever I need it. Hey, Lily, are you ready for your final five? Yes, this is it. We're already down to the last five questions. Just like that.
I believe that's how the interview is that short.
Well, we're not done yet. We'll see where we go upset. Here. Here's where we go from. You'll be sticking around. It's all right.
Okay,
this is just the formal part. Number five. You used to be a florist. What was your best-selling flower?
Probably a peony.
Ooh. Isn't that a small piano? or a fancy little horse? What is a peony?
It's like a kind of like a variation of a rose or something,
okay.
I guess. But it's
there's lots
a
of them in wedding
nice.
Bouquets and stuff, isn't
there? They are in wedding bouquets.
Do you like yeah. big peonies or?
I'm a fan of a massive peony.
Massive peonies.
number four, and this is a visual question. Have a look at the big screen. When will you next wear this outfit?
You know what? Interestingly enough, I was wearing that outfit not 48 hours ago.
To where?
Just in my hotel room.
Number three, will you miss Harold from Neighbours?
I hate Harold.
Well...
No, I'm joking! He's so nice!
Wow, you did everyone just went, what? Everyone simultaneously did a Harold impression.
I miss Madge, though.
Oh.
It's been a while. Move on.
Actually, you know what? It hasn't, because she presents some weird TV programme in England.
Does she really?
Yeah, it's like a property developing programme.
Wow.
She's moved on.
And
that's
I always
good
watch it and I'm like, Madge?
Someone should
what
tell
are you
Harold.
Doing?
Number two, who would you most like to stab with a fork?
Ooh. I couldn't possibly say. I don't know. You.
Okay. Fair enough. No. It's a fair call. And number one, your final question, what's your favourite body part?
Of my body? I don't know, probably my breasts.
You're going to take them both as one? You have a particular favourite out of the two?
No.
It's like children, you can't go, oh, they're all the same.
Well, whichever one's a bit bigger.
It's not your bed!
Extend the interview!
You're not the only one who wants this to go for longer now. All right, here's the plug, the album, It's Not You, It's Not
no,
Me, It's You,
it's you.
Is out now. This is it here. Lily will be back in June for a tour. The tickets go on sale tomorrow.
8th, 11th and 12th.
So you can check out our
8th, 9th and 12th.
Check out our website. All the details are there. Lily Allen, everybody, who will be sticking around.